My name is Brent Wolf, and thank you for tuning into this week's edition of Alpha Sports Talk. And just a quick background on myself, I'm a sports broadcaster for WRSU 88.7 FM New Brunswick, or you can catch us online at WRSU.org. I host a show, WRSU Crew, Fridays 4 to 6 p.m. If you somehow miss that as well, you can find me on Spotify where we upload all of our podcasts. The show's great. We talk all sports. And a little emphasis on Rutgers sports in general. Me, I'm more geared towards basketball because that's where all my knowledge is at. So if you're interested in Rutgers basketball, definitely pay attention Fridays, 4 to 6 p.m., WRSU.org. Today's show is going to be centered on a very important and urgent topic within the state of New Jersey. Anyone who's watching this video should know that Rutgers men's basketball is having a historic season and was firmly on pace to make the NCAA tournament as either a 5 or 6 seed. At one point, we even cracked the top AP top 25 when we cruised in at number 24. Since that moment, we've only struggled. The following week, we moved to number 25 after a loss, and we've been sliding in the polls ever since. I know, right? How could a team that is 17-1, that's right, 17-1 at home, possibly be struggling to make the NCAA tournament bracket of 64 teams? Well, the answer is sure for you. We only have one loss at home, but we only have one win on the road. It came against the poor Nebraska team, in which we won by 17. Nebraska's been getting bullied all throughout the Big Ten play by every team, so analysts won't look at that one that much when trying to vouch for Rutgers to make the tournament. Since that moment when we won against Nebraska, we have not won another road game. But I'm here to argue why Rutgers should make the NCAA tournament despite that. For starters, we have two more games to play, one of them being at home. I want to place an emphasis on that home game. As you can see on your screen, it's March 3rd, this Tuesday, 7 p.m. at the Rack. Packet, Maryland's number 9 in the country. And we win this game, you can scrap this old conversation. Rutgers will be in the tournament. And that's that. But if we would rally off one more win, it would place us at 500 in Big Ten play at 10-10. The Big Ten has been historically hard this year, as many teams are expected to make the tournament, as many as 10. Another aspect is that the Big Ten has heavily favored home teams this year. The best away record in the Big Ten is Maryland, who is number 9 in the country and only is 5-5 on away games. So a team that could possibly be ranked number 1 come tournament time only has 5 road wins and 5 losses. It's a testament to how hard the Big Ten Conference has been on the road this year. Anyway, let's take a closer look at some of these Rutgers away losses. Their most recent away loss came from number 16 Penn State, in which they lost by 1 at the buzzer to a 3-pointer. Their next loss came by only a mere 3 points to Illinois, then by 5 to the best team in the Big Ten in Maryland. Another loss came to number 18 Iowa by 5 as well, then by 6 to Ohio State, 6 to Michigan, and 8 to Wisconsin. Just so you can see those numbers again, it's on RU Mates Watch Twitter. They offer great coverage of Rutgers basketball and all Rutgers sports. They have all those losses listed for you right there. These are all small margins, and every one of these teams are tournament-bound teams. Yes, I do believe Rutgers will need one more win, but with one more win, I believe they can firmly be in the tournament, even as much as a 10 seed in the tournament. Let's take a closer look at these losses, and which RU Knights Watch has detailed for us below. They were called for 62 more fouls than their opponents, which is about 7 more per game, and two of these losses came without Geo Baker and Jacob Young for the Scarlet Knights. Both are offensive juggernauts for this team. Jacob Young, very shifty player, opens up the floor well and can get to the basket with explosiveness. Geo Baker's that clutch guy, third year, 2 years already under his belt in the Big Ten, junior, the face of the team, and really the captain and the face behind this Rutgers team. But my last point is that of the remaining teams on the bubble to make the NCAA tournament, Rutgers easily has the most quality quad one wins, which is what these analysts are looking for when trying to debate which teams make the tournament and don't. They've beaten Penn State, Seton Hall, Wisconsin, Illinois, Purdue, and the list goes on. This has been a historic campaign for the Scarlet Knights team and has been the talk of the town all around college basketball. Head coach Steve Peichel, who was just signed for an extension with Rutgers through the 2025-26 season, So sorry about that. My roommate had just accidentally opened the door, almost done with the recording, but he came in and had to briefly pause it for a minute there. But as I was saying, Rutgers' head coach, Steve Peichel, has just been extended to the 2025-26 season, as deserved, because he's currently nominated for head coach of the year in all of the Power 5 schools. If this team were to make the NCAA tournament, it would be their first appearance since the 1990-91 season. Unreal. Pack the rack this Tuesday at 7 for the game against number 9 Maryland. If they win that game, your Scarlet Knights are in the tournament. Well, that does it for this week's main topic. As always, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and even drop a comment to spark a debate. For Alpha Sports, I'm Brant Wolf, and thank you for watching.